Imagining this asphalt as a vegetable garden takes only a sliver of the faith of Namika Nwakanobi as he walked across one country after another for a new life in the United States.
I slept in the jungle, on the floor, on the ground.
After fleeing Nigeria, he spent a year in a detention cell awaiting asylum in Washington. Now, at 28 years old, he's a free man, able to grow his own food. Nwakanobi is working beside other World Relief volunteers to rip up a parking lot. It will have 50 plots for refugee and other immigrant families to grow food they can't find here.
Tell us why gardening is part of that dream of having a life here in the United States.
Well, it makes you feel like home again. So if you're in an apartment complex and you have no attachment to the soil, there's, you know, you don't have access to land, this is a way to not only grow food, but food that you recognize that you're not able to buy at the grocery store. So now it feels like home again because you're eating food you recognize, you're talking to the neighbors in the plot next to you, and you're having conversations, and your family is doing something with you that's fresh and healthy.
Tamina Martelli says growing a garden of familiar food is literally growing a new life.
A garden is a wonderful way to grow food from your own country that you have been missing, that you can't find at the grocery store, so you're able to eat healthy again and to talk to your neighbors in the plot next to you.
There's a lot of work left to do here, but nothing compared to the work it took to get here.
I feel great. Feel alive. Very happy and grateful.
In Kent, I'm Allison Morrow, King 5 News.